Hey, it's Randy. Today we're going to look at how to interpret change in exponential models when the function that they give us is not in a form that we immediately recognize. Let's go. All right, so before we even read through this question, let's just talk about this box right here. What's the point of this? This is like our help box, and it includes information that we've already seen before, and you'll see why it's going to be really helpful for us as we try to solve this problem. So this first item in the box is the standard form of an exponential model that we're used to seeing. And the second item in the box is one of the properties of rational exponents that we learned in the past. So let's see how we can use both of those items in order to answer this question. So this question says, the number of views, V of t, on a viral internet video in relation to time, t, in months, is modeled by the function below. The number of views increases by a factor of how much each month. And the answer that we should get is 8. So let's see how we can get to that answer. So if somehow we can make this expression right here look like this expression right here, we'll be able to analyze it because we know how to interpret an exponential model when it looks like this right here. But how do we make this expression look like that? Well, the expression that we're given looks like x to the power of a plus b. And according to the properties of rational exponents, we can rewrite this expression as x to the power of a times x to the power of b. So these two new terms will have the same base as the original, but the exponent a went into the first term, and the exponent b went into the second term. So 3t corresponds to a, and 7 corresponds to b. So let's rewrite this expression in the form that we can see on the left right here. So there it is. Now, instead of 2 to the power of 3t plus 7, we now have 2 to the power of 3t times 2 to the power of 7. Now, in our standard form of an exponential model, we have the constant first, that is the term that involves no variable, and then we have the exponential expression that involves the variable t second. So let's switch the order of these two so that it looks exactly like our standard form. In other words, we'll put 2 to the 7th first, and then we'll put 2 to the power of 3t second. Now all of a sudden we have a form that looks basically like the standard form that we're used to interpreting. Now, if you want, you can even convert 2 to the power of 7 to a number with no exponent. So let's do that. 2 to the power of 7 is the same as saying 128. So now that we have the form that we're used to, a times b to the power of f of t, so a corresponds to 128, b corresponds to 2, and f of t corresponds to 3t, we should be able to interpret this pretty quickly. So based on what we've talked about in previous videos, we should all be able to agree now that 128 is the initial number of views before we start analyzing the change in the number of views. And the only part of the expression that we need to pay attention to now as we interpret the change is the part of the expression that involves the variable t. So what do we do with t? Well, they said the number of views increases by a factor of how much each month. What does each month mean? That means every 1 month. So if t is in months, they're saying what happens if we plug in 1 for t right there. So let's plug in 1 for t and see what happens. So the part of our expression that involves that variable t is now 2 to the power of 3 times 1, or we can just say 2 to the power of 3 or 8, right? Because 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. Okay, real quick, before we talk about what to do with the 8, let's just talk about what happens if t is 0. Well, that makes this entire exponent 0, which makes this entire expression on the right into 1. So 128 times 1, or 128, is the number of views when time is 0, before we start analyzing. Now what happens if t is 1, that is 1 month? Well, this entire part of the expression, 2 to the power of 3t, becomes 8. So let's put 8 in that place right there. Okay, so when t is 1, that is 1 month, b to the power of f of t is 8. So every month, the number of views increases by a factor of 8. So there it is. The answer is a factor of 8. Let me prove it to you by seeing what happens if we plug in 2 months for t instead of 1. You'll see that the number of views again increases by a factor of 8. Okay, so there's our new t, which is 2. 3 times 2 is 6. And 2 to the power of 6 is 64. So what did we do to get this 64? We just multiplied by 8 again. We multiplied by a factor of 8. So now that I've proved it to you, let me just say that all we really needed to do is just plug in 1 for t, because they're asking about every 1 month, and we would see that this part of the expression is in fact 8. So the answer is 8. All right, there it is. Let's apply that same reasoning to another situation now. All right, there is a certain plant that grows very quickly. Its mass, m of t, in relation to time, t, this time in days, is modeled below. By what percent does its mass increase each day? And this time we need to round to the nearest percent, because we're going to get a really long decimal as our percent originally. And the answer we should get is going to be 7% when we round to the nearest percent. So in order to be able to interpret this function right here, let's convert it using this property of rational exponents to this form right here. All right, we're getting close. Now let's put the part of our expression that involves the variable t second, just like we have it in that standard form. All right, there it is. Now we have a times b to the power of f of t. And you'll see that this time I'm going to leave 1.29 to the power of 5 as a power, because I don't want to write the super long decimal that we would get if we actually put this in the calculator. So we'll just leave it as to the power of 5. So they're asking us about the percent increase in mass each day or every 1 day. So we just need to plug in 1 for t and then see what that does to this entire part of the expression. All right, so there's our 1 in place of t, and we don't need to worry about this first part of the expression anymore because it does not involve a variable. So let's put this in our calculator and see what decimal we get. So the way I do that is first type 1.29 and then use that button that means to the power of, and then parentheses 1 divided by 4, close the parentheses. So when you press equals, you should get 1.06573, and that number keeps going, right? So how do we express this as a percent? Well, first of all, we could say that the mass increases by a factor of 1.06573, right? But what about as a percent? Well, we just need to know the distance that this number is from 1 and then multiply by 100. So how far is this number from 1? Well, we could rewrite that as 1 plus 0.06573. So that number 1.06573 is this much more than 1. It's that distance from 1, 0.06573. All right, now let's multiply that by 100, and that will give us the percent increase. So multiplying by 100 is just moving this decimal 2 places to the right, and that will give us 6.573. Now, how do we round this number to the nearest percent? Well, this 5 after the decimal tells us that we're going to round the 6 up to 7, so we get 7% when we round. So as this plant grows, its mass increases by 7% each day, just like we saw as the answer that we should get. If you still feel a little bit shaky on that conversion to the percent, you can always go back and look at the video titled Interpret Change in Exponential Models, and that'll help remind you how to do that conversion. All right, and now that we've practiced using the properties of exponents to convert our function into a form that we recognize and are able to interpret, we are finished. See you next time.